$2,095.
Over $2,000. I think in 5 years, that's how long I've been here, that's only the second time we've gone over $2,000. That's awesome. And I just want to thank you all for that. I know that it was a struggle. I know that it was a struggle getting people to do it, but that's how God works. God moves us in different ways that we least expect. The other thing is, yesterday, some of you spent the morning in the rain. I want to thank you for that also, for helping with the bean gathering. It was interesting because they came up to me afterwards and said they needed to pick my brain, and I said, oh. And the questions were because there were congregations here that they didn't know. So there were at least five from Southeast Penn, Southeast Pennsylvania Synod, which means the Philadelphia area. There were at least five or six also from North Penn Conference. And I thought there was another two from the rest of them. So it was awesome. And every year we say it starts at 8 and we end at 11. But guaranteed, the majority of the work happens between 8 and 9. 8 and 9. So then we sit around and get to know each other. So thank you for those who helped yesterday and for those who helped to create the quilts and school kids. So yesterday, also then in the afternoon, then we had a fundraiser that Sandy hosted. And how many people did you say you went through?
18.
18 people went through. It was a come as you are, come as you want. So we'll know more about that because there's still an online aspect of that fundraiser. So that's pretty cool too. So I give you thanks for all of that you continue to do to support the ministries of this congregation. So at the organ today, we have God.
I have two of them. One was a friend of mine that lives in upstate New York. She makes lotions and stuff, and she sent me a bottle for free. I didn't even ask her to pay for it. I didn't ask her to send it to me. She just sent it to me for free. The second one is my best friend. She always comes through whenever we need her to.
Cool. Friends. Friends make us who we are. Unexpected love.
On Wednesday, the New Holland parade was, and the next morning I was heading to work, and I noticed all the trash and everything left behind, as happens after the parade. And it was really bad down at work too. And then later, when I took a break,
very similar interest that I never knew. He just started sharing how he has collections of old newspaper articles, of lifetime events and all of that. I have two boxes of stuff that he never knew that I had. But he was talking about different stuff about that. And then also the other thing too is, as a part of the ceremony, you have to meet many of the men and women there who supported him in his promotion. And that there was one man that had only been working with Bradley for 2 months. 2 months. And he had to come up to tell me, he said, "Your son is a gift. He is the only one that showed me what I needed to know while here on the base. And I'm a Navy man."
Wow.
But that's also what happens when you work on a joint base. A joint base. So yeah, proud parent moments, but also a gift to know that what we do matters, and what all of you do matters, and you never know. You will never know how much you influence other people. May we continue to embrace that as part of our journey. With that, let us take a breath. Let us breathe in the air around us to give us peace, so that we might exhale love into the the Spirit who makes our joy complete.
Amen.
Let us bow before God in humility, confessing our sin. Steadfast and faithful God,
you have revealed the ways of justice. We have failed to follow you. You are overwhelmed by the world's violence and suffering. We are afraid to risk what we have for the sake of others. For the harm that we have caused, known and unknown, forgive us.
For the unjust demands we place on others, and for creation,
forgive us. For the ways we turn away from you and our neighbor, forgive us.
Lead us back to you,
and set us on the right path. In the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen.
Beloved in Christ, God's justice stretches beyond all of our understanding. God's compassion is beyond compare. In Jesus, God is always making a new way for us. In Christ, you are already and always forgiven.
Amen.
Thank you.
Beloved God, you came to all things that are good. Lead us by the inspiration of your Spirit to know those things that are right, and by your merciful Christ, help us to do them. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated.
The first reading is from the third chapter of Philippians. Paul writes, "If anyone else has reason to be confident in the flesh, I have more. Circumcised on the eighth day, a member of the people of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew born of Hebrews, as to the law, a Pharisee, as to zeal, a persecutor of the church, as to righteousness under the law, blameless. Yet whatever gains I had, these I have come to regard as loss because of Christ. More than that, I regard everything as loss because of the surpassing value of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord. For his sake I have suffered the loss of all things, and I regard them as rubbish, in order that I may gain Christ and be found in him, not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but one that comes through faith in Christ, the righteousness from God based on faith. I want to know Christ and the power of his resurrection and the sharing of his sufferings by becoming like him in his death, if somehow I may attain the resurrection from the dead. Not that I have already obtained this, or have already reached the goal, but I press on to make it my own, because Christ Jesus has made me his own. Beloved, I do not consider that I have made it my own, but this one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead. I press on toward the goal for the prize of the heavenly call of God in Jesus Christ." Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Do to those tenants. Well, he said to him, he will put You have to water them, then you have to pull the weeds, and then you have to water them, and then you have to trim them back, and then you have to water them, and then you harvest the fruits, and then you water them. Oh, I forgot to water them. I didn't water them as often as I would because I depend upon nature to do that. That didn't work very well this year. And then there are some things also about gardening that I learned this year too, is I will not be trying to grow my own plants anymore from seed. That just did not work for me. Just did not. I mean, there was one tomato and the squirrel had a feast. There were beets that were the size of peas. And beans, I think, that were the size of the first knuckle of my pinky finger. So one day I just kind of like moved to bed and all that kind of stuff. If someone were to come up to me, you know, and the thing is, so true, this is true. I had really hoped that I could grow vegetables that I could give away. I really hoped that I would grow enough to give away because I don't eat vegetables. I do, but you know what? If the owner of that land would have come to me and asked me to give them the harvest, I would have had nothing to give them. Okay, so now I already see the conversation. You are the owner of that garden. How many of you are saying that? Or how many of you are saying, well, we own that garden. I live on your property. I am so glad that none of you came asking for the harvest. Because you would have gotten Zippo. But I don't think this story is, you know, and you all know this by now, I'm sure. This story isn't about the vineyards. It's not about the garden. It's really about our relationship with the owner of all that we have, God. God. And I know that in some traditions, and Lutherans in particular, that may be a hard concept for us to understand. But everything that we have comes from God. Everything. Now, how does that work? How does that really work, you know? So let me give you some ideas of how that might work. So first of all, if I ask you where you see God, what is your usual response?
Everywhere.
Everywhere! Everywhere! And if I ask you to share God moments, which many of you have, where is God at in those moments?
Everywhere.
In the people. In the people. In the people. In nature. Yeah. We see that God is everywhere around us and in nature and in other people. Did you ever think that you were one of those other people? Have you ever thought about that? Have you ever thought that maybe you are one of those other people? Really? I struggle with that. I struggle with that, to know that God might even be, the essence of God might be in me. Just in the same way that the essence of God is in you. Yeah, you. You. Every one of you. And that the essence of God is also in everybody else that you encounter. And that may be hard, for, at least I'm going to say, from my own experience, I was always struggling.
Jesus.
Care about people. Care about others. And when you care about another person, you are caring about God. You are caring about God's nature. I know we all laughed when I talked about the pea-sized beets and the many weeds and the watering that didn't happen. But if I relate that to my own life, I could think of many other things of where I was not exactly the best person in relationship with other people. Any of you there? If any of you tell me you're not, what are we gonna do?
Go to lunch.
You're taking me to, I'm taking you to dinner. Yeah. Yeah. So one of the things that I've been getting to kind of more fully understand about my faith is that really my faith is really about how we engage with other people. How we engage with other people. You can be the best biblical scholar on earth, but if you can't relate to people, the harvest is not produced. The harvest is not produced. Yes, there are some people who think that's the way. And yes, there are some people that, you know, say you've got to do this and this and this. Oh, great. But they are just part of the process. The process really is, how do we interact with one another? How do we show love and kindness and mercy? The harvest that he talks about in here are the fruits of yes. And they are love, joy, peace. Right, we'll learn that in January again. We'll learn that in January. The fruits of the Spirit. The fruits of the Spirit. Yeah. I wonder, this is one of my wonderings. This is one of my wonderings. As a community of faith, how do we view God? How do we view God? And can we see God in each other? Can we see the human form of God in our interactions with people? Oh, yeah. The people that have hurt us by words or maybe physically. The people who have harmed, and we are part of the people who have harmed this earth. I think what this text is calling us to is that, you know, we do our best. We do our best. We do our best, even knowing that sometimes we are going to mess up. Because how often does God come to you? How often does God come to you?
All the time.
Do you remember that truly? I don't. But yeah, can you imagine that you are loved so much by something so much larger than you that God will never, ever, ever leave you? Ever. But that same God also calls us to care for his vineyard, or care for God's vineyard. And where is God's vineyard?
Us.
A place in which we live. A place in which we live. So the work that we do as God's people isn't really about us. Sorry. You're going to feel good about it. Yes, I feel good, great about stuff too. But really the harvest that we are ready to reap is in the people that we meet outside of these walls. Well, hundreds of thousands of people who will be blessed by quilts, personal care kits, and school kits that were loaded I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord.
He was
conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit
and born of the Virgin Mary.
He suffered under Pontius Pilate,
was crucified, and died on his burial.
He descended into hell.
On the third day he rose again.
He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Amen.
Trusting in the transformative power of God's loving Spirit, let us pray for the church, the world, and all in need. God of grace, you are the source of life and joy. Strengthen the resolve of your church to follow throughout the world, that together we press towards the goal of your heavenly call in Jesus Christ. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
God of all creation, you plant and nourish the earth as your own precious vineyard. Bless the fields and orchards in the hands of those who labor in them, that your people are fed with an abundant harvest of good fruit. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
God of all the earth, you desire peace and justice between nations and peoples. Guide the leaders of nations, states, provinces, that they faithfully govern your people with wisdom, integrity, and compassion. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
God of all compassion, in Christ you lovingly poured yourself out like wine for your people. Have mercy on all who mourn, who struggle with their mental health, who cry out for justice, who hunger, and any in need, especially Betty, Deb, AJ, Dennis, Don, Vicki, Scott, Jennifer, Dave, Sharon, and Debbie. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
God of all steadfastness, you set Christ as the cornerstone and foundation of the church. Build up this congregation as living stones, that it stands in the community as a witness of your enduring faithfulness and love. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
God of all hope, the saints who came before us lived and died with their hearts fixed on you. We give thanks for their faithful witness, and we wait with hope for the great day when we join their voices of praise. God of grace,
hear our prayer.
Gracious God, into your hands we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your unending love and amazing grace. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
O God of power and God of plenty, all things belong to you. We bring your gifts to this table that all may be fed. Form us into the body of your beloved, Jesus Christ, our Savior, who first taught us to pray, saying,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
The God